Hey, my name is Andre, and it's late at night. The kids are asleep, and I just want to show you my actual work. And I start with a little jam with the things I recorded on the day, and now I arranged it on the Octatrack. I used the analog Rytm, the analog 4, the OP1, the electron analog heat, Nordstage keyboard and a sub 37 and a guitar and some vocals. A lot of stuff packed into some patterns, and I just jam out. And after that, I try to deconstruct the song with you. If you're interested, I just show you how I did this on the Octatrack. So enjoy.
Thank you.
So basically that's the track, and now I want to show you just the things I did. I just divided this song into two parts. I'd like to do the naming of the first part with the beats per minute of the entire song, so I can remember it if I go through my different songs. And I have one part without the slice mode on the vocal sample, and the second part is for all the other patterns where I don't use the slice on the vocals. I think it's only in one pattern. It's pattern 3 on this track here. Just turn off all the others and go to the single one. So this is some random slices played through the pattern. Let's start with the first pattern. Here it is. There's two vocal samples on the first slot, here and here, and here's a guitar, another guitar, another guitar. Here is actually nothing, I guess. Maybe another guitar, and here is nothing. I think here's also guitar. So basically some static machines for the guitar stuff and the vocals, and the rest is coming through the MIDI tracks. First one is the piano, and the seventh is the sub 37, and the track 8 is the OP1, only used on one pattern. And basically, if I show you what I got here on the piano, it's just some chords playing. I played it live, and after now the sequencer recorded the MIDI notes, and it's just playing it back. Same for the sub 37. With one more thing, I have two CCs applied to change the LFOs on the sub 37, and also the filter. And this is parameter locked on the sequence. Okay, so this pattern once again, all together. And the rest comes from the rhythm and the analog 4 that are connected through the other part of the Octatrack. Yeah, the way I work here is I started to record flex machines, the samples, and then I saved them to the static machines, and now I play them backwards, forwards, and have different effects, mostly a filter and a reverb on most of the tracks. And altogether on the track 8, I have the master track set up with a compressor and the freeze delay effect I showed you on the little performance thing. Another cool thing I found out during programming this sort of song is that I use one-shot tricks on most of the parts that come in and come out. So basically I have parts that stay all the time that are just the melody, and then I have parts like guitar or vocals that I can arm, and then they fade out. So I programmed the one-shot tricks, as you see on the playback page, on the M page, with a hold and release that is not infinite. So the guitar starts and then slowly fades out. Slices on the vocals that I showed you. So just some slices applied. You can also see the P-locks on the sequence. And another weird thing here is the sub 37. It sounds weird too. I can show you the mixer. Turn off everything else, and now. That's just the sub 37 with some P-locks applied to the filter cutoff and to the LFO that's changing a gate, sort of. Yeah, that's this part, that's this pattern. And this is sort of an interlude, and now the chorus sort of thing. Oh, and by the way, this is just the thing you hear in the background is on the rhythm. It's a cymbal played backwards. The lo-fi effect with some distortion applied, and a reverb so that it sets through the mix and fix my bad vocals. But it works. And the last part is this ambient conclusion, I would say. It's just a piano track with a bowed guitar with a lot of reverb. I love these chords. And this is the bowed guitar. Piano, I guess. Yeah, thank you for watching. This was a little rundown of my work, and I hope it was interesting. Maybe not so much, but I'm sorry it's late. Thanks for watching.